Do you know the viral StudyGram trend? StudyGram originates from the two words study and Instagram. It is where communities of students from all over the world would have accounts dedicated to making aesthetically pleasing notes. These accounts have thousands and some even millions of followers. Creators would spend hours and hours with fancy templates and stationery to make attractive notes. They would use expensive applications on electronic devices or write their notes out in neat handwriting, with lots of decorations like stickers and washi tapes. I really admired the creators for juggling their school life and note-making hobbies. It surely couldn't have been easy for them. The time and energy dedicated to craft such amazing notes, I was impressed by not only the product, but also the time management of the creators. Well, this was because I, on the other hand, had already found myself stuck in such a busy schedule, studying up to 2 a.m. on days even without examinations. And I still scored below my expectations. It made me think I was in a lonely battle, fighting this top-tier boss, and that I was slowly burning out, soon to be defeated. I constantly felt lost, trying to find out what went wrong. It seemed as though the efforts I put in never really matched up to my grades, and at times I felt like giving up. My heart was full of bitterness. It felt unfair. No matter how hard I tried, how much I studied, my scores just never seemed ideal. So I kept looking around in hopes to find an answer, but to no avail. Until one day, I realized on deeper thought, maybe it wasn't a problem with me. I just had not discovered the right technique. I was not any less intelligent, less capable. I was just lacking the right technique. But then, how do I find the right technique? With access to technology, efficient and useful study techniques can be sourced online. So finding the right technique shouldn't be that difficult, right? Well, apparently not. Not at least for me. If you had access to my YouTube homepage, you'd see many videos on study techniques. If I were to compile all my knowledge in a book, it would be as thick as an encyclopedia. And still, with all this information, I couldn't find a definite answer. Frustrated, I looked to my classmates in hopes of finding an answer, but to no avail. I asked one of my friends. Let's call her Friend A. Friend A's revision technique involves using muscle memory and cramming 3 days before an exam. Otherwise, you would find her spending most of the time, if not watching Twitch streams, she'll most likely be scrolling through YouTube or Instagram. As much as she appears to put in little to no effort, she always excels in examinations. And although it might not sound the most effective, it works for her, and she's getting the grades she wants. So I thought to myself, maybe this was the answer. This was the secret technique I was looking for this whole while. And so naturally, I tried this method out for myself, and I must say it went terribly wrong. It made me think regardless of how much effort I put in, it didn't matter. My results never showed the fruits of my labour. I constantly felt defeated. To that extent, it even got me thinking at one point if she was truly born a genius and that I should just accept my fate. But no, I was not to give up this easily. If she can do it, so can I. So I continued looking around, determined to find answers to improving my scores, and in the process, I realized many of my friends were indeed struggling the same way I do. Maybe it wasn't a lonely battle after all. Remember what I said about the StudyGram trend? I thought maybe since so many people were doing it, that was the answer. Maybe if I started to write my notes this way, it will work better for me. And so, I started to copy those methods and style of writing notes, and it took me hours and hours to do so. I thought I was doing the right thing, until the very day of my exam, when I sat for my paper, and the horror when I realised I had actually not learned much. I was so obsessed with the appearance and perfection of my notes, and learning became a backseat priority, and had not helped me in my academics at all. But the StudyGram trend could be useful to someone else. Making aesthetic notes can improve productivity of the creators and encourage them to have better organisation, to see the fun in learning, and be motivated making these aesthetically pleasing notes. But for me, it wasn't the right one. This proves to show that study techniques are not one size fits all. It's inevitable we have to dedicate days, if not weeks, months, or even like me, years to find the right study technique. Finding the right study method takes time and cannot be rushed. It's not easy. It is something for us to discover ourselves and cannot simply be solved by watching a 15-minute YouTube video. We should not rush the process and always keep in mind that the end result will make it all worthwhile. My process of discovery took me very long. To find what was effective and comfortable, I had to be patient with the process and do a lot of self-reflection. There are so many available study techniques out there, from highlighting, mind mapping, rereading to rewriting notes, like an overflowing jar of candy. but maybe only some candies suit your taste. Maybe you might not like the flavor of some, just like not how all study methods can work out for you. We perceive and absorb information differently when presented in different methods. We need to find our own way and not let the jar of candies overflow, causing a huge mess. And only through constant trial and error can we find our own methods. For me, since I've discovered this method called active recall, my studying time has reduced drastically and my study-play balance was more in check. I no longer needed to dedicate so much time to studying and was able to improve, if not maintain, my grades. Beyond study methods, we cannot keep comparing ourselves to others and expect things to work out the same way they do. Even in the future, while working, we need not necessarily follow the standard procedures or be fixated in a certain method. We should not be afraid to find our own way, to discover what works best for us, so as to yield the best results. Even if it may go against normal practices, if it works well for you, don't be afraid to keep to your own methods. What works best for others may not be what works best for you. I hope you've stopped blindly following trends, but instead discover their own unique style.